Hello and welcome to Hank Games Without Hank. My name is John Green, manager of the AFC Wimbledon Wimbly Womblys with two seasons left in their football League One campaign. We've already won the league. At this point, we're just playing for poops and giggles, as my son likes to say, because he doesn't know about cursing. I think he actually does know about cursing, but he hasn't, like, told us yet that he knows about cursing. So today I would like to acknowledge that I am wrong about everything. So one of the pleasures of being not just the manager of the AFC Wimbledon Wimbly Womblys, but also the point person for Nerdfighteria's sponsorship of the real-life AFC Wimbledon. For those who don't know, the advertising money from this FIFA series goes to sponsor a real-life football club in England called AFC Wimbledon. And I recently was celebrating the fact that AFC Wimbledon will be playing at Wembley on May 30th. Come to the game, by the way, if you live in London, and say hi if you see me. Don't make it weird. Don't make it weird, but say hi. It's fine. Love to talk to you. Just, but don't scream. And I'll talk about that in a different video. Anyway, one of the pleasures of being the point person for the Nerdfighteria sponsorship of AFC Wimbledon is that in addition to, people who work for the club and actually root for the club watching this FIFA series, by the way, hello to all AFC Wimbledon real-life supporters. I occasionally get emails from the CEO of AFC Wimbledon, Eric Samuelson, and I got one such email over the weekend in which he pointed out that in my most recent video about AFC Wimbledon going to Wembley, I was wrong about more or less everything. He did this in the most polite way possible, which is typical of Eric. He's just a super guy, and I'm not just saying that because he might be watching this. I'm a huge fan of his. He, both as a administrator, as somebody, you know, who has to run an organization, and as a father and a family person, I have to say he inspires a lot of my thinking. Oh, what a great ball, but it just didn't quite come to fruition. Are you hurt? Or are you just frustrated? It's okay to be frustrated. We already won the league, buddy. That Lyle Taylor, he's got no give up in him. He wants to win every game, no matter what the situation is, and I really respect that about him. Anyway, Eric just is such as a father, as a and then as a business person, like, big inspiration to me. I love the way he thinks about community and yeah, he's just a great guy. But he emailed me to point out that I was wrong about pretty much everything in my video about AFC Wimbledon going to Wembley. Here's Lyle Taylor. Lyle Taylor. Lyle Taylor. Oh, Lyle Taylor. Get there. You got to get to that ball, buddy. When that ball is flashed across the box like that, you got to stick out your leg. Jego, a little frustrated with himself. So let's begin with the fact that Paul Robinson is not the captain of AFC Wimbledon, which I knew that. Buckminster Fuller is, or in real life, he is known as Barry Fuller. He is a lovely guy. He has two beautiful young children who were part of a pitch invasion after AFC Wimbledon secured a spot in the playoffs. I think they're two little girls, like 5 and 3. They're just the cutest little things. He's got an awesome wife. I follow her on Twitter. So yes, of course Barry Fuller is the captain. I don't know what I was thinking. Paul Robinson, however, an important part of the club, for sure, and a very hardworking, really talented guy. Come on, it's gotta be! Oh, what a point blank save! Rotherham desperately trying to stay in this game, but you've got to say AFC Wimbledon has had the better of the chances. Shea LaBeouf, I don't believe, has so much as touched the ball so far. Although, as soon as I say that, oh no, Jago tracked him down. Secondly, I said that this was AFC Wimbledon's first game. The game on May 30th would be AFC Wimbledon's first game at Wembley. That turns out to be untrue. AFC Wimbledon, when Wembley opened, this is actually an amazing story. They played a club called Corinthian Casuals. So my understanding is that Corinthians Casuals, or I don't know exactly what they're called. I'm trying to play a FIFA game right now. Oh, off the post. Shea LaBeouf still hasn't touched the ball. Corinthians Casuals is a club formed, a mix of two clubs that kind of united, Corinthians and Casuals. And I guess the Corinthians is famous in England for their, like, their sporting, they've been, like, steadfastly amateur, treating soccer as the amateur sport that it originally was, and also for in their old in the olden days refusing to take penalties because they found them to be ungentlemanly, which Here at the Wimbly Womblys, we never refuse to take a penalty, but we do often miss them. Oh boy. Okay. Everything is fine. Why is Rotherham so good at this game? Anyway, Shay and both have it covered. No big whoop. So, when the new Wembley opened, they included a bar called Corinthians, but apparently they didn't have the right to use that name. So, Corinthians compensation included a game at Wembley, and Corinthians could have picked anybody to play at Wembley back in 2008, but they picked AFC Wimbledon. And so AFC Wimbledon did get to play at Wembley in 2008 when they were a non-league side in a game in front of about 5,000 people that AFC Wimbledon won 8-1. By the way, Eric pointed out to me, oh no, gosh, we're having some trouble today. And then we try to pass it out of the back, which is a huge error. This is just a disaster. Everything's going to work out though. Don't worry. We've got Jego on the ball. He's fast. He's a sprinter. He's going to pass it. That's a nice pass. Lyle Taylor sprinting into the open field, as he always does. Lyle Taylor just sees space differently from other people. And it's a great pass! Oh! Yes, finally! The opening goal from T.S. Eliot, who scores not with a bang, but it must be said with a bit of a whimper. But a great pass from Lyle Taylor. T.S. Eliot misses his first opportunity, makes his second. Really good, I have to say, great thinking there from Lyle Taylor. And then T.S. Eliot, with his beautiful left leg, reaches out and on his weak foot finishes calmly, coolly, and very attractively in the 45th minute to give us a halftime lead. Just what we wanted to have happen today. Everything is going pretty well for the Wimbly Womblys at the moment. I am well contented. Oh, Lyle Taylor. Lyle Taylor. Lyle Taylor. Lyle Taylor. Oh, he passes it. Oh, and it's off the post. Lyle, he's too unselfish. So, in short, AFC Wimbledon have played at Wimbledon at Wembley before, albeit only in front of a crowd of 4,500. And I heard that more than 10,000 AFC Wimbledon fans have already bought tickets for Wembley. So you really should get a ticket. It's going to be incredible. Also, Eric let me know that even though the game is, that Simon Bassey played in the game. So Simon Bassey got to play at Wembley. For those who don't know, Simon Bassey is now the first team coach at AFC Wimbledon and has been for a long time, but he was an early player and he has an incredible story that I guess I can tell in the second half since I've already made all of my corrections. Although I'm sure in making my corrections I've added new incorrectnesses because I am just the worst at telling true stories. I would be such a bad reporter because I only like telling the stories that make sense to me or that I find attractive with no real consideration for whether they are true. Oh no! Oh yes! Everything worked out. Whew! We are a little bit sketchy at the back in the last couple games, and we're gonna have to figure that out because we're gonna play Tottenham in the FA Cup final, a game that I can't help but think of as relevant to the interests of the actual AFC Wimbledon. Of course, I don't believe in magical thinking, but if I did believe in magical thinking, I would believe that if we won the FA Cup, that maybe Wimbledon will in turn win their game on May 30th at Wembley. It's almost too much to even dream about, though. I'm so excited to go to that game. I feel so lucky to be able to go. So anyway, so if you're not familiar with the story of Simon Bassey, it's pretty incredible. He started out as a youth player get there! Oh, a little bit overcommitted, Lyle. Started out as a youth player for the original Wimbledon FC, but he was dropped by the club, I think in his early teens. That was back when they were still in the Premier League, and he didn't quite make it, you know, to that level of wasn't able to make it on that level. Wimbledon always had a really strong youth outfit too. So anyway, he became a cab driver and played non-league football. You know, he's down in I think the seventh and eighth tier of English football. But professionally, he was working as a cab driver. And then when AFC Wimbledon formed in 2002, he was one of the 300 people who came to the open tryouts on Wimbledon Common, and he made the team. Played with the team. I think he had 81 appearances. That's almost definitely wrong because of all the numbers that it could be, why would I remember the exact right number? But if he did have 81 appearances, then I'm very impressed with myself. Meredith, can you Google how many appearances Sam and Bassey made for AFC Wimbledon? Anyway, he made several, made a bunch of appearances over the course of a few seasons, including this great run where AFC Wimbledon went undefeated for almost two full years, or even maybe more than two full years. They had this incredible run through the ninth and eighth tiers beginning in 2003, I think. And so Simon played for them for a long, long time, but he has the distinction of having never scored a goal for AFC Wimbledon. And in his final game, he was the AFC Wimbledon were up like 5-0 or something, and the players encouraged him to take a penalty. They got a penalty, and the players were like, "Simon, you got to take it, you got to take it." They handed the ball to him. Simon took the penalty and missed. So he was able to retire with a perfect goalless record. And then became AFC Wimbledon's first team coach, a job that he, or I think originally he was the coach of the reserves, but anyway, he's been working with AFC Wimbledon ever since, and he's been part of the club ever since, and has been with them. So he's one of the people who's been with them, you know, in the ninth tier, and now we'll be going to Wembley for a game, a single game to play into the third tier of English football, which would be incredible. It's always been my dream to sponsor a third-tier English football club, as long as it's AFC Wimbledon. He's just an incredible guy, and really great guy, and I think captures for me a lot of what I love about the spirit at AFC Wimbledon. How many appearances did he make, Meredith? 46. That's probably right. I don't really know what was up with that pass, but I do know it's 2-on-1, which we usually score from. Oh, man, their goalkeeper is having a world-class day. Congratulations to Colin with an unnecessary L on his fantastic day as Rotherham's goalkeeper. All right, big ball in. We never score from corners. Wow. Bicycle kick, huh? Must be the end of the season. We've got nothing to play for except for joy. Wait, speaking of which, I should make substitutions. Oh, man, people are going to be so mad at me, Meredith. I let both T.S. Eliot and Lyle Taylor become extremely fatigued. Also, I forgot to put a second striker in, so I'm going to have Barcham play up there, and then we're going to bring on Reevesy, and, well, that's all the ones I have. So I apologize to Tunga. He looks very tired, but, you know, he'll be all right. He'll be okay. Everybody's a little bit tired. I probably overextended. I probably hit the trigger too much in this game. Oh, no! Wow! Wow! We pass it out of the back, even in extremely dangerous situations. It's just who we are as a club. What, is that the end of the game? Did I not get to make my substitutions even? Congratulations to AFC Wimbledon on their thrilling 1-0 victory over Rotherham. Again, I apologize for all the inaccuracies. And thank you, Eric, for taking the time to write me so that I could tell the incredible story of AFC Wimbledon's first trip to Wembley. They're undefeated at Wembley, friends. Long may that continue. I will see you next time. Thank you for watching. Best wishes.